Hello friends, today we'll be taking up a very different pen. I'd been waiting for it for quite some time. There was initially a delay due to the shipping issues with the pandemic, and then there was some problem with the components. But I must tell you, it was really worth the wait.
Here we go again, passing judgments even before the arguments have been heard.
So you've joined work already?
Yep, I'm forced to.
I won't waste time squabbling with him, so I'll just get on with it. Today I'm taking up a pen which is very interesting. It is Platinum Curidas, and this is one of the few pens with a retractable nib with a click mechanism. Pretty interesting. By the way, do you know that the name Curidas is a neologism? There's a person in our fountain pen group, Sakshi, and she told me that this is a neologism between an English word curiosity and a Japanese word kuridasu, means to uncover. So kind of a cool name, huh? Don't you feel so?
Curied by...
Hey, language! Well, the case, there's a cardboard sleeve and there's a cut at the end, so you can remove this plastic case. Black colored, you've got this branding here and you've got the branding here. And then this opens to reveal the pen, which is housed there. And you remove this small insert and you have a guidebook. There are certain interesting tips, it's just not waste. And you have a cartridge. It's a cartridge converter pen, but then the converter doesn't come with it. And it has this small plasticky thing. Don't lose this. This is very important part. Basically important to remove the clip and then put it back again. You would need this. Don't lose this. Huh? So these are the things about the case. Do you have to say anything?
Man, what's with you people and the case? The case is just to deliver the product to you. And once it is with you, you've taken the pen out and put it in your tray, you'll just store away the case in your storage somewhere. You won't even care. It's like you're writing with the case, you're talking about it in so much detail. As if your life depends upon it.
Why are you so getting so touchy about it? It's just a case.
My point exactly. You know, it's not his fault. It's actually your fault. You've been liking all the crap that he's been doling out to you. And that's what has emboldened him.
Boomer. Okay, I get your drift. Let's just leave it at that. Let's get to the pen.
The pen has an acrylic body, and this one is particularly the clear demo. It had few other colors, and I must say all of them look beautiful. The writing section houses the flap or the shutter, and this is the way you see, and this is small assembly which is on the upper part of the writing section, and this mechanism has created a hinge and it necessitated this small stub underneath. There you see the trapdoor putting a fulcrum there and opening up, and this is sort of created this small stub here. There's two railroad kind of things. You can place the pen like this, but then it is not a pen rest and the pen doesn't have a good stable resting part on this. Now the writing section is very broad, and here is where you expect the grip to be, and this is free of any protruding parts. As such, the clip is removable, and after you have removed it, there is just a tiny stub on which this clip anchors. And let's see how this clip is removed. So I'll have to take utmost care using the same plastic stub which I had shown to you in the case. So I'm going to use that, and all the instructions about its removing are mentioned within the small booklet which I had put there. So what do you have to do with it? There is an arrow, and you have to, if you have to remove the clip or put it, you have to use it in this particular direction. So you engage this underneath, you engage this underneath this window and it lifts this window from the stub underneath. You have to do the same here, and with one hand you have to try to push this outside. Here you see it's getting removed, and at the same time you have to push it up and push it out. Let's try doing that, and there I have removed this. So the clip is out, and after the clip has been removed, you see that this is a very tiny stub on which that window anchors, and this is the stub where this, the upper part of the clip fits, this one. This one. The clip is pretty functional, very usable, I must say. And once you've got that out of the way, there's no issue with the writing section. There's no disturbance there. The girth, well, some of you may find that girth to be an issue. Not really sure. It's pretty comfortable for me. Now, once you remove the nib, and you see that this nib unit, this one has a branding of P Platinum there, and it's a medium steel nib. This one is a kind of a like a vanishing point nib, and it sort of latches onto the feed. There were issues with the feed for the cracking up, and then that's what delayed the shipment for the major part of the batch. Now the barrel opens up, and you find the nib unit. Let me remove it. Now this is the nib unit. The converter is housed in this small metal cage. Now you'll have to very delicately remove this. You see this small stub, you'll have to guide it outside. There you remove it, and then this nib unit is out. And again, to remove the converter out of it, the cartridge or the converter, you have to again take care to remove this out of this small assembly there. Now this is again out of this, and you can easily do your thing, fill the converter or the cartridge. Now at this moment I don't have the converter with me, but you would have the roll mechanism, the knob of the converter protruding out here. So while you're filling the converter with this, you won't have to remove all this cage, metal cage out. You'll just have to do that. Twist it back in, and then you push it into the spring, and then taking care that this assembly fits again. Pretty neat, huh? To many people it looks cumbersome, but to me it feels like you're loading the old time rifle. And then I put the barrel in again. There. Now this clicker is very huge. You'll see this click fitting into the cog there and then doing its thing. Now this is pretty huge, and I don't know what has prompted the design. To some it may be not an issue, but I felt there is a bit of deal with it. The clicker is huge, and so as you grip the pen for short writing sessions, you can't immediately in the same grip click it back, as it's pretty long. So you'll have to change your grip and do that, and every time you have to do these kind of things. So while I was taking short notes, doing some lessons, it was somewhat annoying going back and forth with this. Keeping it in pocket is not an issue, because the clip fits slightly lower on the writing section, and but a lot of the part of the pen is protruding up. Now let me just try to put it back also. So since it will go like this, it has to be done with the aid of this. Arrow goes in the opposite direction because the cap clip has to slide like that. I know this is going to become a long video, but I can't help it. Just drop this, picked it up again. It's kind of messy. Okay, so you see all that. I won't edit it out, huh? We need to know that these things are a bit tricky. So I've put the notch against this stub, and I'm holding this against this window, and I'm trying to push it, and then I'll try to slide it on the small stub. Yeah, on both the sides. There you go. I think with after two or three times you'll be perfecting that, but I won't fiddle with this much because I don't think that these small plastic parts are going to hold much longer. They may break and then you're done with the clip. So after you have put the clip back in, it will fit into your shirt pocket neatly and the clip is good. The upper part would be outside jutting out. That will be just a bit of oddity out there. And the nib is, as I said, it's a slip off mechanism. The nib can be slid off this feed, but I won't fiddle with it because of the issues of feed cracking. If I have to compare it with a vanishing point nib, there's the comparison. Both of these nibs are almost of the similar mechanism, but then you can see that there is a size difference. Now this particular vanishing point is missing its converter cartridge, so the click is not working, but otherwise you can see that the size of the pens there, a vanishing point with the Curidas, and you see that the girth of this writing section is pretty wider than that on a vanishing point. We'll make some comparisons at a later video of these two. Let's do some size comparison with some different pens. With a different pen, there you go, and another one of the regular pens. This is a Platinum Century. The main issue with this was to fit it into a standard case. This is a Franklin Christoff case which I use, and it barely fits into it. There you'll have a bit of issue finding a perfect sleeve for this particular pen. So the size, the length, dimensions, you have it as just more than 15 centimeters, and its weight is 26 grams. Okay, now to the best part, the writing with this particular pen. This is a Platinum Curidas. It's a medium steel nib. This is a clear demo pen, as you can see. The ink is Colorverse Supernova. And the paper is 68 GSM Tomo River, and this is a endless recorder. Let me just halt and come to the nib, because that is what has been the most striking part of this pen. Now the nib is the best part. I immediately loved the moment it touched the paper. Very unlike a standard platinum stuff. The perfect balance, perfect smoothness, wetness and feedback which you get with this nib. And you feel it just gliding across with a perfect feel of paper. No issues at all. It's a medium nib, but I find it writing on a slightly wider scale than a normal Japanese pen. Now, nib on that matter, I will do a comparison with other nibs from Platinum on a President and a 3776 Century on my Instagram, and you can check those images. Otherwise, the nib is great. This is a small tiny nib, so I won't flex it much. Reverse writing. Oh, this is the first time I'm doing it. I must say I'm very surprised. You can use it as a reverse writer, as a usual reverse writer. Let me try that once. My, this is a revelation. Okay, I don't know whether all the nibs will come like this, but it can be used as a reverse writer, and it won't harm your tripod grip, and the middle finger will rest just in front of this clip, and you can use it as a reverse writer. Good job, Platinum. I am impressed. Okay.
So, overall verdict, Professor Kahn, what do you say?
The pen is good.
What? That's all? The pen is good?
You've been giving your verdict all along. What's left for me to say? You've already passed the verdict. You can write the closing arguments yourself.
Oh, come on. I've said my stuff. Now, say what you have to say.
The monstrous click is a pain and I wasn't very comfortable fiddling with it while writing short notes. That's my issue with it.
For me, the issue was the disproportionate writing girth and the size of the nib.
Okay, just hold the pen.
What?
I said just hold the pen.
What do you mean hold the pen?
Would you please freaking just do what I'm saying? Please hold the pen.
Okay. Don't just get violent about it.
Now just click the nib out.
Yeah, so?
And now you tell me, how do you plow your field with that?
Plow the field? Are you crazy?
But you were talking about the size of the nib as if you are gonna dig a hole with it. You are just going to write with it, so tell them how it writes.
It writes well.
The bounce, the spring.
Yep, decent. It's good. So what do you say about the rest of it?
It's decent weight, it's decent girth, writes well, so it's not very pricey, so that won't pinch. It's demo, you can see all the mechanism underneath, and it's super industrial, so I like all that functioning and springs, whatever is clanky going on in there. But it's plastic, so if you drop, I think you're done with it. And if I'm not mistaken, this is probably the first acrylic fountain pen with a click mechanism. I may be wrong, but I haven't heard of many plastic click pens. So I believe they've done a pretty good job.
Well, I won't drag that further now. I'll just wind it here and I'll see you soon.
Go and make the world a better place.